I am not ready.
Me neither.
All right.
Hey.
Hey everybody. This is how it's opening. It is what it is.
Yep.
That's Brian. I'm Bill, and this is Talking Overtime.
Yes.
Thanks for the cheers. This is a show where Brian and I get to act like idiots for a little while and chat about Mask, and well, not a little while. It's 30 minutes. We try to get it right around there. We have a co-star, the Wheel of Illusion, in the mug for you. Colt is going to be going out soon. This might sound very cheap. I'm sorry. I'm waiting for Redbubble to have some coupon codes on that front.
No. So then, good idea. You know,
so that way there I can get them out. And we have to announce the winner of the last mug. So if you watched the last episode and participated and commented and liked, you got a chance to win a mug. And it just so happens that a recent guest of the show won this mug. Now, she was in an episode not too long ago, and her name is one second, hold on.
Tip of your tongue?
I think it began with a D.
No.
I think it was a D. You sure?
Positive.
Oh, you're right. It was an L. Lisa, that was me toying with you, Darcy. I'm sorry. Lisa, you won the mug actually through my random picking. So I will reach out to you about that as well.
Random? That seems more corrupt than the recent election results.
Well, no, what I do with the comments, I don't know if you watched the one episode where I talk about it. When I'm working, I'm over here on the one screen and I'm just going up and down, like scrolling through the comments or whatever. Mm-hmm. And I just randomly stop whenever it lands on. I can probably do like a name generator and do it that way, but.
No, it's not that big a deal. It's not that, you know, it's not serious. It's a mug and you do it the way you want to do it.
And on this episode, there's going to be another giveaway, so I'll announce it in a little bit, maybe after the first wheel spin, but it's going to be all exclusive. Oh, I can't give it away, but you're going to be staying at Brian's house.
Hey, come on down.
No, it'll be another giveaway coming up in this episode, so stay tuned for that, and we'll talk through that. But Brian, I don't really care how you're doing. I don't care how I'm doing. I want to get into the wheel, but
no.
We decided this year, so we were going to do something a little bit. We were going to try to do something, and it never came to light, essentially. But essentially, we each got each other a Christmas gift or a holiday gift, whatever your terminology is. So before we start spinning everything and getting into the actual detail of this, I don't know if you want to exchange gifts now or do you want to do it at the end of the show?
Doesn't matter to me. I have it. Might as well get it out of the way.
All right, so if you want to grab yours, I got you this. We had some rules on it. We said no mask items, just because we have mask items. We wanted to make sure we got, you know, went that route, and we said it couldn't be explosive. So those were the rules. Okay, there you go. Mm-hmm. So go ahead and open it up.
Let's see what you got. Sick. Let's see what I have here. Oh, Mr. Met.
I'm glad he made it.
Mr. So Brian's Met.
A big Mr. Met fan.
I am.
And I thought, you know, I thought to myself, I want to get him that. So he's opening it right up.
I'm just going in here.
Brian, your choice of packaging was very strange. It's the best day ever. Now,
best day ever.
Does this mean every time we talk, it's the best day of your life?
Every day. I've just done that every day. Every other day, I've just topped it.
It's just weird that you wrapped it like this.
I don't know why
you got Christmas paper inside, and then best day ever.
This thing won't come out of the plastic. I'm just going to stop for now.
Oh, wow. You got me the Philly Fanatic?
Oh, who knew?
We couldn't have planned that any better.
We could not have.
Well, thank you for that, sir.
Hey, behind the scenes, we wanted to, like, do something where we got into like a fake argument and then got all huffed and like walked off. And then we like, you know, we mended ways with these Christmas presents, but I don't know. I just couldn't get mad at Bill. So we just
kind of kind of the same sentiment, really. It's like I can't act, right? And I thought about it. I thought about how to do it. It was my idea. But then I was like, it's not going to work. So it wasn't given.
No, it would have come off like, damn you. Damn you.
Let me get in the character.
See, I can't. Good luck. Cut.
It would have taken us 18 hours to get one of anything.
No, they all would have been bad takes.
Brian and I are both big baseball fans. He's a Mets fan. I'm a Phillies fan. But we
does yours come out of the plastic easy? My guy's like living in there for life.
He's like in here, like
it's like embedded in this thing.
Yeah,
finally, like he's free. Oh, he's free. Thank you. This guy in person is so obnoxious. He's the worst.
Stuff around his neck. There we go. You froze.
I'm frozen. It was you to me. Am I back?
You're blank. There you are.
Yeah, right.
So, yeah, it was a nice little gift. Nice little gift.
Yeah. Every time I look at it, I'll think of you, especially when they lose again and again like the Mets do.
But I appreciate that. And a little more housekeeping before we keep going here. I'm going to have a top 10 of the PSAs coming up on the Behind the Mask portion of the show. And yeah, that's going to be a good one. And we're working on a couple of cast interviews as well. So stay tuned for those. And if you haven't done so already, there's another YouTube channel out from the maskforce.com page. There's a really, really cool acoustic cover that they posted. And there's a couple of commercials too. And I'm sure that Rob and company will be, beefing it up a little bit. But
yeah, that's a great start to the channel. That little intro they have, it sounds like I go to this dirt mall by me and they always play like that Muzak throughout the like thing. As you go there, you'll hear like, popular songs just done in like that style. And I'm like, wow, this is like the Mask Muzak version. I liked it a lot.
When I first heard it, I was like, damn, that is really well done.
You have to be able to pay somebody to do that. Like there must be some kind of Muzak site or something.
I bet there's probably like an app you can get now on your phone.
Yeah.
I'm not saying this is what was done, but like you can like play a song and it'll play it in a piano form or acoustic form for you. If not, then I'm going to invent that. Patent pending.
Hold on. There's a battle we have to tend to. Be right back.
In which episode did Gloria Baker first appear? The answer is The Star Chariot, Episode 2, Season 1.
We got him. Now back to the show.
And we are going to take a look at the wheel. I'll leave it up here for a second so we can see the selections we have. Actually, I'll scroll down first because it's easier to read it this way.
Mandalorian, generic Venom agents, favorite racing series uniform, best 80s cartoon theme songs, top 5 80s cartoon characters, least favorite toy, least favorite mass power. How do you define rare? Those are good categories.
That's where we're at. And we're going to give it a spin and see what we get. I'm guessing it's going to land on one of these 8.
I'm going theme songs. Oh, I thought I was right.
By a millimeter.
So close. Racing series. Okay, I'm just looking.
Your favorite uniform out of the series?
Out of the racing series?
Yes.
It's not H. Riker.
You don't like his silver and gold outfit?
No, that is horrible. Looks like some kind of alien thing.
Let me see if I can guess yours, and you can try to guess mine.
Okay, mine's gonna be a little different, but you're probably gonna be close.
I think it's Ali.
It is Ali. I think I'm deciding between Ali and Bushkin.
Boris is a good one.
Boris is great. I love that costume. I'm gonna go Ali though, because Bombay. It's great. Tracker's good too, though. In that, I like the Matt Tracker outfit.
So which one do you think is mine?
If I had to bet yours, we're not counting Vanessa, right? Because if we are, it's Vanessa.
No, because Vanessa's, Vanessa would just win automatically, I think.
Well, your joke answer is going to be, what's his face? Rushmore. But I'll say that your real answer is Miles Mayhem in Buzzard.
No, it's actually Goliath Tracker.
Nah, it was obvious. I don't know why I didn't guess that.
It's one of my favorite ones, but I also like the, I do also like the repaint of Dusty as well. In Nevada, while, you know, his mask power is not great, it's a really good figure, I think.
It is. He's cool.
But, and we're not talking about least favorites in the two. We're talking about our favorite. So I'll let you start off with Ali real quick here. And you can talk about why that's your favorite one.
Well, I'm.
Your audio cut the whole thing.
So I'm going to have to explain it again.
I got you there. Hold on.
All right. Wow. Fun internet. Ali's just awesome. Like, it's sleek. It's not messy. It's not complicated. You could see, like, with Ace Riker, they were just trying too hard, and I don't think it worked. Like, they just went crazy with them. And the best outfits are usually the ones that are a little simpler.
Ali's is, I mean, it's a unique choice to take on that purple mask with the outfit that he has on, but it works in that aspect because red, you know, the red and the blue are going to make purple. So it's kind of points upward. And at the end, that's where you're at.
Did you hear me say that when I got cut out on the internet before? Cause that's what I said. I said blue and the, I said originally I had this answer where I said the blue and the red, you know, make purple. And that's, I think, why it works. The color schemes work like that.
And you cut out. So
and then I cut that out. So all that's on the, yeah.
I'm going to have to edit that portion now. So I got you now, though.
Great.
Now, for me, the Matt figure. So if anybody's been watching the tier list that I've been doing with Dave, I don't hold like the Spectrum outfit in high regard. The Ultra Flash, I think, has more going on with it. The Goliath one, even though Matt's a little bit shorter, there's a lot going on here. There's a lot of detail. I love the color palette with it, the yellow and blue. I'm a sucker for like that color scheme, yellow and blue. And you had a little bit of a pop of the red on his mask for Shroud. Like, there's multiple ways to look at that. Not only does the mask power create a Shroud, even though Spectre could probably do that too.
Yeah.
You have the Shroud going on it, and it's just a pretty cool dynamic in my opinion. It's one of the better Tracker figures outside of Ultra Flash. I think is probably my favorite one, even though it's not the most powerful one.
Probably my second behind Jungle Tracker. I like it. You know what it is? It's primary colors: yellow, blue, red. Bang! That never fails. Anything that's done in like those color, you know, rules of color, it always works. Half the time when I'm doing artwork, I think of that. I'm like, oh, what should I do? And I just go, yeah, red, blue, yellow. Just, you know, add different darknesses and lightnesses. Go for it.
Oh, there's our favorite ones there. So we got to spin the wheel again. I'm going to guess Venom Agents.
I'm sticking with my pick. Theme songs. I want to talk about that. Come on. Wow, we just keep going through least favorites, most favorites. All right.
Or Nevada.
Well, yeah. That's where it's going, right?
Well, you started the last one. I'll start this one. All right. Considering that we don't know the powers of the split seconds figures, let's consider them all, you know, not there.
The powers are to look hideous.
Well, 97% of them got that covered. We're looking at we're basically looking at series 1 through 3, you know, essentially.
Yeah. Well, that's what I own. So that's what I'm looking at anyway.
And the worst mask power. Now, I've made fun of Totem a lot. You know, it shoots a totem onto the ground and there you go. And it's supposed to explode, but it seems like more of a minor nuisance than anything.
Yeah.
And I actually think that Boris Bushkin's mask power is probably the worst.
What does it do? I see. I'm shaky on some mask powers. I'm like, wait, what do they do again? I go in and out.
It's kind of he shoots out like red stars and it's supposed to like,
yeah, burn, you know? I remember that. Yep.
Let me look. It's the Comrade mask. I'm going to look it up real quick just to double check to make sure I have the name right. But the Totem, so like,
Totem's been on so many different levels. You
know, that's Ultra Flash already. So we have that already in, in that realm. So do we need to have, you know, the rest of it? Like, do we need to have a second mask with the same?
No, it's a little redundant. A little redundant.
I'm sorry. So it's confusing the enemies. It is Comrade, but still.
It confuses them.
A flash, you know, it shoots red stars that confuse enemies. So, yeah, it's the same premise. I guess that would be okay if you're driving around, but how are you gonna point that at somebody if you're in a really, really heated race? You can't really take your eyes away from the road. Like I said, it's probably gonna be a mix of like Totem and in that one. I just don't know which one it would be. But if I'm leaning heavily, I might still have to give it to Nevada, actually.
Yeah, me too. But does Shroud just create like a smoke screen? Is that what Shroud does? So like for racing, I guess that's okay, but I don't know. That's a little weak too. But there's no way that it's not Nevada Rushmore. A, there are so many things wrong with just throwing the Totem thing out there, whether you want to talk about microaggressions or whatever, that it's a sign of the times of the 80s. Or like if you're the Indian character, it's just like, hey, you got a Totem. So I mean, it's what, you know, society was like, and we're different a little bit now. I mean, the Washington football team. And then it's just really lame that it just shoots little axes and that's what you have to offer. It's not anything special.
Yeah, they just fall on the ground and they blow up, maybe.
Yeah, it's nothing.
No, at least we're in agreement there. So like Boris is very for me. What would you say like he's a close second?
Of garbage mass powers, I really don't like Shroud at all. Like, it's just, I don't know. I looked at it, I'm like, wait.
Yeah, it just makes it dark. It's like,
it's a smoke screen. Oh, I can't see where he is. There he is in that black cloud. Oh, like, I can't see.
Yeah, just follow the black cloud. It's like that character from what?
Or, Peanuts? I drove into the black cloud. How do I get out of this? Drive out of it. I don't know. It just seems a little lame. I mean, as a kid, I'm sure my imagination would have ran wild, but as an adult, I'm like, oh, good.
Exhaust. I'm going to draw this black cloud on the wall.
Yeah. Exhaust.
Well, there we go. That's what we got there.
I like every mask power. I do.
Uh-huh.
I'm a sucker. Worst mask name is Penetrator, though. I'll tell you that.
I love that one.
What is it coming at?
How do you define rare?
All right.
Well, for me, I never really want rare because I like my steaks well done. Just full disclosure. I'm one of those people. I don't like a lot of red meat.
Oh, medium rare, at least.
I'm mostly poultry. But I, you know, not to go off too far here. We were at a friend of ours' wedding. they had fish and steak, and I don't like fish. So I was like, if I can get the steak well done, it was like
flame. That's rough at a wedding to not have chicken. You know, come on.
It was like filet mignon or something like that. It was like a high end cut or whatever. And get it. I asked. I was like, can I get mine well done? They just looked at me like I was crazy.
You are crazy. Is the difference? Yeah,
but they brought it out, and I think the chef might have been mad because literally,
did you dip it in ketchup?
It was charcoal.
Yeah.
I couldn't even cut into the damn thing. So I was like, "I'll eat this asparagus."
Yeah, great. Yeah. It's rough to have only fish and steak at a wedding. You gotta have chicken. You just have to.
Yeah, it was odd. But I mean, my wedding, we had Thanksgiving dinner.
Was it near Thanksgiving?
It was in October, but I really wanted Thanksgiving dinner. So we had like really upscale stuff with it. My wife got to pick all the hors d'oeuvres and everything. So
classy.
You know, it was nice. It, you know, everybody likes Thanksgiving. You should celebrate it. And
rules.
You know, good turkey and you know, stuffing, potatoes, cranberry. Like it was all.
I still can't believe you burn your poor filet mignon. You gotta let that thing bleed. It's so good.
Well, like I said, I can't eat it that way.
Oh, it's so good. I could talk about that.
I was ready to take it outside and play hockey with the damn thing.
No, I can talk about like ribeye for like all night.
Sticks were in the car. I was ready. It was that hard. I was cracking up at the table. They're like, "Were you drunk?" I'm like, "No, look at this thing." Like, they gave me a hockey puck.
Hey, you get what you ask for. What was the question again?
What is rare?
Oh, that's how we got on this. Rare. You can
throw it out there.
Like, you know, obviously we know what rare means, but as far as, you know, what it really means, like you can't find masks in every store you walk into, right? You can't find vintage 80s stores in every store you walk into, but I don't think a lot of them are rare in the sense that you can still find them a million different ways, whether it's online or, you know, Facebook group, all the Facebook groups, eBay, you know, Mercari, all that stuff. So rare is rough. Obviously, like Laser Command's rare because there's less of them produced than Thunderhawk. So just a numbers game is rare. But like, you know, yeah, what is rare? Stuff that like there was a G.I. Joe playset made out of cardboard that was sold for a little while and that thing was going to get destroyed over time anyway. I think it's called Missile Command. So yeah, that's going to be more rare than like.
Was that for the 3.5
Yeah, it was like 1982 Sears catalog, I think, only.
Oh, so that was my first launch then.
Yeah, it was. It was the first thing. It came with, I think, a Cobra Commander and a Trooper. Again, I'm rusty. But it was made out of cardboard. Like, so of course it's going to be rare. Like, there are certain things that are just going to be rare because of the materials that were made out of and, like, they were used in toys. So, again, I have some toys down here that are hard to get your hands on right now, but I don't know if they're rare. They were like mass produced.
I'm saying that all the time. Look, I'm trying.
What's going on?
I tried. I couldn't get in there.
Oh yeah. Good luck. Like I have like I don't know. I have a lot of stuff that I think is rare. I had to like, you know, hunt for it over the course of time, but like nothing that you couldn't go on eBay and spend money for and find.
Yeah. No, and you're right. There's elements of it.
It's a numbers game.
Well, it's a numbers game essentially, yes. And as you say, Laser Command, that was one of the things that was like low end produced toward the end of its cycle of everything. But there's different ways of looking at rare too. So I have a mask hat over here. Mm-hmm. And while it's rare right now, it's only rare because these were thrown away.
Yes.
You know, exactly. These were made in God knows how much quantity. I know Chris from Full Force has one that actually fits his head. This is a child size one.
Yeah. It
doesn't fit me quite well, as you see.
Like that costume behind you, the Tracker Halloween costume. Once upon a time, you could walk into any department store in America and find that. Now it's rare. You know what I mean?
And you know, a lot of these things are rare, hard to find, as you can tell by the price points that you're looking at online. But you have the main line of the things, right? You have the main line of the toys, the figures, but then you start getting into things like the cell animation. Those are hard to find.
That's different. That's rare. Like
especially for Series One.
I'm talking about
rare in a sense. And like, I have this wallet that I've never seen before.
Yeah, there's going to be way less of those than there are like rhinos because.
Like, how rare is this? I don't know, but I don't see it. Way and should I make it my primary? I talked about this before. I haven't done it yet. I might. And then you got this thing, you know, the Mesk set.
again,
you know, with Wolf of Brindley, Miles Mayhem going on here.
Yeah, I would never open that up.
It's already been opened.
I guess you can slide it out.
But, like, you know, this is rare because you can't find it anywhere. They were produced in individual packages, but they didn't have MISC on it. They had MASC.
That's so funny.
They finally got around to spelling it correctly, I guess. I don't know. But that's how I define rare. The stuff behind me here, there's stuff that's rare here. I know you have stuff that's rare in your room. But again, you got to look at production numbers. You got to look at what survived. You have to look at, you have to look at all those elements. And
if you have an eBay account, you can go on eBay right now and buy everything. If money wasn't an option, you could go onto eBay right now and buy everything I have in this basement, basically in the next hour, just click, buy it now. I mean, you'd pay a lot more than I did for it doing it that way. That's how I don't think my stuff's rare, because outside of the fact you probably have to spend more money to get it, and I've like hunted and like really bargain shopped to get my collection this way. Like, I don't know if it's rare, you know?
So like up here, I just told him my camera up. I have that Miles Mayhem slide puzzle above the kites.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and like I never saw that before. I didn't have that when I was a kid. Is that rare? I guess.
Yeah. But
that also might mean that I got lucky and found it. Now, there are things of limited run that come out, not really in the MASC line, not on purpose anyway. And as time progresses, you know, the Meteor and the Manta are not going to be rare anymore.
I was just thinking that. I was just thinking the Chili Fine takes things that were a little more rare and like totally makes them not rare. Like Meteor.
And that's fine. I mean, unless your collection is like, I'm doing this to sell it. I'm doing this for
I'm not in this for money. I'm not a reseller. I only resell to buy more toys. I don't resell to like survive. And it's just like
this year, that's history. This is my, except for the Dynamo, I put it there just because, you know, it was sealed. That's history right there.
Yeah, mine gets a top shelf of my Detolf. I don't know if you can see it from here, but yeah. Mine gets top shelf every time.
Yeah, I got it there. Yep. So, I mean, rare, and you know, this is going to be something in the comments that people are going to be hopefully talking about. And I want to hear your opinion on it. Like, how do you define rare itself? There's a lot of ways to look at it as different collectors, collect different things. So,
I don't know. Can you see the Bionic 6 playset down there, right there?
Yeah.
Yeah. I passed on one for $50 in 2008. I forgot to bid, and it sold in a box for $50. Since 2008, I've seen like three of them on eBay. One of them went for like $500. One of them's listed for $500 now. One of them was listed at $1,000 for like the last 6 years, and it just sold to somebody.
Well, the Vortech episode I just did. Vortech is not out there at
like,
all.
Like, Bionic there's like more rare than MASC.
There's like 25 listings, maybe 20 on eBay. Most of them are the same, and they're high prices. Some of those cost more than MASC vehicles, and that's a rare thing to find. Like that's rare. Finding Vortech on DVD is rare because it doesn't exist.
Yeah,
you know, that's how you define rare. Just because something isn't easy to find doesn't mean it's rare. It just means it's not easy to find. So it's a hard thing to put an actual definition on when you're collecting. I would consider rare to be, like I said, you're going film animation.
Yeah, I think hard to find and rare are a little different. Like, I wouldn't buy a MASC vehicle incomplete because some of those pieces are hard to find. Like, you can find them, but they're hard to find. Like, does that mean they're rare? I don't know. Maybe there's tons of them out there, but they're hard to find.
Well, yeah, and like that. The Goliath steering wheel for $100 on eBay right now.
Yeah.
Hard to find. It's not rare.
Yeah, I have one, so I'm good. Thank God.
Yeah, I got one too. So yeah. That's how I kind of go that route. And before we go to the next wheel talk, we got a couple minutes. The next giveaway.
I have a horrible joke. You know who likes things rare? Alf. He likes his cats rare.
I'll do a rim shot in there somewhere for you.
Oh God, just shoot me.
um So I don't have an actual prototype here for the giveaway, but through the Redbubble store, you'll get a MattTracker.com mask.
Hey,
like this.
You're literally keeping mask fans alive. Look at that.
Yeah. So then that's the next giveaway. All you have to do is comment, you know, give us a like, and you know, hopefully watch us. I don't know.
I don't know if I'm the most. I don't know if this is the most popular show on your channel, but I like hiding in my basement talking every other week. So let's keep it going.
But no, that's the next giveaway. So on the next video, in 2 weeks or so after this, we will post the winner of that. So we got a couple more minutes here to get the wheel going again. This is our fourth topic. So, you know, we had a couple smaller ones in there, but it works out pretty well.
You know, some of those are just so, some of these are, oh, it's going to be least favorite toy, just to keep in the theme of favorites tonight. The wheel, shoot, does favorite this, least favorite that. Oh. These wheel topics tonight are just killing me. Come on.
I'll start to hopefully help you. All right. So Venom has these agents, right? And something I thought about for a while. Why do they have like two of them? Like, hire more. How cheap are you? Like,
two guys.
You have two guys standing there to do whatever the hell they're doing.
Is it really just two?
It's like there's probably a couple episodes. I think Video Venom maybe was one where they had a couple.
They have like the orange like visors, right?
Yeah, and sometimes they're
over commander.
Sometimes their masks are off. They don't have masks with powers. They all look the same. Are they clones? I have no idea. But why, you know, in an episode, how come that couldn't have been like a, hey, look, we got to fight, you know, we got to fight off all these thousands of clones here. I know it doesn't really stick with the premise of the show, and those guys are there probably for filler mm-hmm. because they couldn't figure out a way to maybe at that time incorporate other characters, but...
Yeah, and Venom was always shortchanged on characters.
You know, it's...
They didn't have, like, a huge army to select from. They had the four people, for the most part, in the first series, you know?
Yeah, and I don't know. It was just funny. Like, they'd be standing guard, and Scott and T-Bog are right by them, you know?
Yeah, those guys are the worst.
Maybe get, like, you know, another guy in there. It's like...
Had I really, like... And I had no memory of them existing. Had I remembered they existed at all, I think I would have had like an army of those guys in Mask 85. I think I would have had like just a whole army taking over the country and showing it. But I totally forgot they existed. And I didn't watch the cartoon till this past summer after I was done with all the comic books. Because I didn't want to like change an idea because they did something similar or do something different because I saw something.
And it was just always a weird premise. And luckily, you know, we have some... You know, some gifted customizers out there, Mass Shark and Customs, who I've talked about a lot on this channel. He every so often he'll do a carded set on eBay.
He has like a two pack, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's cool.
He does a really good job. I don't know if anybody else is making them. Maybe not they like are. That. I don't know. But those ones are really good quality because he's doing them all by hand. Like, those are. He's doing a lot.
They look like they would have been on the shelves in Europe, like, and I never saw them as a kid. And be like, I would believe they existed if I saw those for the first time. Like, those were sold in Europe.
Yeah,
you know.
You know, it's he does pretty good quality work. He did my customs for Thunderball and Ramp Up the figures mm-hmm. for those, and you know. One day I hope to have him on the show too, just to talk through his work process, because I don't know, he must have the steadiest hands in the world, because some of the painting he does is unbelievable.
Yeah, that separates a lot of custom jobs. That paint job.
My hands are like this when I'm painting. Yeah. You know, it's like,
I'm pretty good with that.
That was one. So that's one of the reasons why, like part of what I did growing up and in the college was I was studying art essentially,
mm-hmm.
But my hands weren't steady enough to work with, you know, pad and paper, you know, or a pen and paper or something like that. It was always hard for me to to take what I was doing and then try to convey it down there correctly, because my hand was so unsteady, especially painting. I really wish I had some of my old paintings. It would have looked like your kids had done it 5 years ago.
You got to just incorporate that thing into your style then. You got to have some, like, you know, Jack and Pollock thing going on. Where you're just
shattering it. Yeah, it's
play to your strength.
It's something. It really was. But I was happy to find, you know, ways of, you know, working with the computer and things like that. And I know that you work with a computer to draw a couple things, right?
Sometimes.
So I don't know. Do you have any closing thoughts on the Troopers at all?
No, they're so forgettable. I had no memories of them until I saw, honestly, that Tupac was the first time I ever remember, it jogged my memory. Wait, that was a thing. And then I started watching the show. I go, oh, I think they're in the episode with the Magma Mole, maybe. I think I can remember them.
They're probably, let me double check here. I think I have them in my appearances list.
Again, for a guy who's on a mask show, my mask knowledge sometimes dips in, you know, tank.
No, I'm almost positive I have them in my appearances list. I just have to.
You know, they never did anything of consequence. They're not stormtroopers, you know.
But I think it was less than 10 episodes they appeared in. I'll post the, as I'm editing, I'll post it up here. I just don't remember off the top of my head.
Yeah, but, I think tonight the wheel went out of its way to pick the exact topics I did not feel like talking about. the things it didn't land on were Mandalorian. I could talk about that all night.
Maybe the next spin will be able to be Mandalorian.
Please. It's been up there for a month. By the time we get it, the season's going to be over.
But now, before we close up, what's some of the stuff you're working on now over on the Instagram and Twitter channel?
I just finished up a lot of commissions the past 2 weeks, so I haven't really been doing art for myself. I've been doing art for a couple other things, nothing crazy. And now I'm just doing weird Street Fighter stuff, just playing around. I'm trying to do something different so I don't get bored. So if I have some less than stellar art coming out, it's because I'm taking chances.
Yeah. Or it's because I helped you with it.
I handed it off. Yeah, no, I'm trying.
Well, as always, I appreciate you hopping on.
Thank you.
Again, if you stuck through to the end of this, comment, give us a like on here, and I'll be picking a random winner to win a face mask. Lisa and Colt, your mugs will be going out soon as the optimal Red Bubble coupon comes out.
I bet you it's going to be Lee Evans this time. Lee Evans.
Lee won the light switch cover.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
There you go, Lee. Good job.
He won the light switch cover. So we'll see what happens. But, you know, it's if same people are going into it, same people have a good chance of winning.
Maybe he'll win.
Yeah.
There you go. Beautiful.
They are. Good old Fanatic.
Merry Christmas from Talking Overtime.
Yes. Well, we can't say that. It's
Happy Holidays from Talking Overtime.
Correct. We have to say, we hope you enjoy your day later on this month.
Have a good day at some point in the future.
Yeah, have a good day at some point. But no, if you celebrate anything, you know, from now until the end of the year, I hope it actually is something you can actually celebrate safely. I hope you're staying safe at school, not at school, whatever you're doing.
I'm not. I'm quarantined. So.
I'll be not at school or at work probably until 2022. Probably, you know, it's going to work out. But people that need to get it, I hope they get it soon. And I hope it doesn't cause any ill effects. But
Mr. Look what happened to his head. It turned into a baseball.
I know. Mr. Matt.
First examples.
And the Philly Fanatic.
He was once a man.
Yeah.
Once a man.
Yeah, he was a man in February.
Yeah.
Man.
That's what happens.
Really, really, really stuck out that way. But, Brian, always fun to hop on here for a little bit with you.
Definitely.
So, Brian is he's up here right now, but I think when it records and edits, he's going to be this way. So, until next time. Thanks for watching, and we will talk to you later.